We're back where we started our journey, Zurich. Like Basel, the seamless network of trains and trams makes getting to and around the city fast and easy. Looking around, you notice how clean, green, and efficient Zurich is. Switzerland is landlocked, but the beautiful Lake Zurich and the gentle Limmat River provide Zurichers with picturesque views of their city. No wonder, year after year, Zurich is rated as the most livable place on the planet. The city is also one of the wealthiest in the world. Zurich is where the financial heart of Switzerland beats, to the tune of trillions of dollars deposited in its legendary bank accounts.
If Basel is quaint, Zurich is cosmopolitan. We start our tour of the city at the center of the old town, where ancient meets modern.
The old and new coexist in Zurich, and that's the city's charm. Medieval streets and buildings aren't for show. Locals work, shop, and live in these. One of the most charming neighborhoods is around Oberdorfstrasse. Today, it's an eclectic mix of shops, specialty bookstores, antique dealers, and art galleries. Explore ancient alleyways, little changed from the days when guilds and craftsmen built this part of town. In the old town, you'll never know what you'll find. Zurich's most imposing landmark, the Grossmünster, towers over this medieval neighborhood. The Romanesque cathedral is visible from almost any part of Zurich, and it continues to define the city's skyline and its place in history. Originally built as Zurich's preeminent Roman Catholic abbey, Grossmünster played a key role in the Protestant Reformation that swept Europe in the Middle Ages. The Swiss reformer Huldrych Zwingli began his radical movement in this church.
The best way to end your day in Zurich is to climb to the top of any one of the many church towers of the city to catch this breathtaking view.
Better yet, start your first day here for an instant orientation to the city. All of Zurich's important sites are visible from up here. Just below is the Limmat River and the historical bridges that stitch the city together. The Rathaus, Zurich's old town hall, still stands here. Over to the horizon is Lake Zurich. On a clear day, you can see the Swiss Alps in the distance. To the north of the city, buildings like Europe's top university, the Federal Institute of Technology, where Albert Einstein studied and taught. Zurich has a low-rise skyline. Only the old church steeples and clock towers defy the building code. Clocks like this one at St. Peter's help synchronize the rhythm of city life. Across the Grossmünster on the west bank is Zurich's second most important church, the Fraumünster. Better known today for the stained glass windows created by the modern art master Marc Chagall.